Hello everyone and welcome to the fourth episode of The Spirited Monk. Today I'm going to talk about one of the most iconic cocktails that has lived the test of times, the Bloody Mary. You know, as a young boy, when I was still in my hotel school, this was one of the first cocktails that I got acquainted to during one of my outings as a waiter, as a casual waiter in one of these banqueting services. And I saw one of the servers carrying a whole tray of this red drink in a short fat glass, looked red and beautiful. And I asked him what this drink was all about. He said, Bloody Mary. And I think the Bloody Mary was considered as the cocktail by most consumers around, you know, in the 90s, at least in this part of the world. It was one of those iconic cocktails then. This is a drink which was invented probably in the 1920s at the Harry's Bar by a bartender called Fernand Petiot or Petty or Pitu, whatever. But it is an old drink and it consists of vodka with some tomato juice, Worcester Tabasco. So it's a nice spicy drink with vodka and tomato juice. And I have been making Bloody Marys throughout my life. And in the last 25 years, I would have made millions of Bloody Marys. And the reason why I also call it an iconic drink is because it has always been there at the bar, in people's mind, and in most parties or events or even in bars that we work, we have to make a Bloody Mary. It is also interesting because this is one drink where I've never ever got a compliment for, because every time I make a Bloody Mary and give it to a customer, he always says, wow, that's a nice drink, but I think I make a better Bloody Mary than you do. So I felt that whenever a customer knows about the drink, it's a very difficult drink. So I've always said the Bloody Mary is the most difficult drink to make for a bartender. Now, my relationship with the Bloody Mary also goes to a later part of my life when I became a wedding bartender in India. And weddings in India, especially in the northern part of India, is a very big thing. And Bloody Mary has remained as the drink for the Indian wedding, especially the mehndi, which is during the daytime. And it's remained the signature drink of all mehndi functions in weddings, right? And I've made Bloody Mary in big buckets, huge buckets. And I've done all kinds of things to the Bloody Mary, you know, right from putting the coriander to the green chilies to the chaat masala, rock salt, all kinds of things. You can put anything to the Bloody Mary, make it as spicy as possible, and people just love it, right? So there have been instances, and I've learned in the course of my making of the Bloody Mary, that it has to have spice, okay? It has to have that color, and it can be as fancy as possible. So the present day Bloody Mary that I make does not go in a roly-poly glass anymore. It goes in all kinds of fancy glasses, like stem glasses and straight tall glass and all kinds of fancy glasses, except for a Bloody Mary or a roly-poly glass. I hate the roly-poly glass when it comes to the bar. So any bars that I consult or any bars that I set up never ever have a roly-poly glass in the bar. So today what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you to the bar, show you a typical Indian wedding Bloody Mary, for which I never get a compliment, but I still have to make it and I love making it. All right, ready for it? Come with me to the bar and let's fix a wedding Bloody Mary. Come along. मेहंदी है रचने वाली ब्लडी मेरी है शादी वाली. हेलो एंड वेलकम. एंड टुडे व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू फिक्स इज अ ब्लडी मेरी व्हिच इज अ चटपटा ब्लडी मेरी प्योरली मेंट फॉर द इंडियन वेडिंग्स, द सिग्नेचर ड्रिंक ऑफ द मेहंदी सेरेमनी. ओके, सो फर्स्ट थिंग्स फर्स्ट, दिस इज अ वेरी चटपटा पेप्ड अप स्पाइसी ब्लडी मेरी. सो इन ऑर्डर टू फिक्स द सेम, आई एम गोइंग टू टेक अ मिक्सिंग ग्लास and start with the classic Tabasco. So 1, 2, 3. Ideally, if I was making a classic Bloody Mary and using the Tabasco, and especially in India, I would actually use almost like 6. But for now, since I'm going to use the green chilies a little later, 3 drops of Worcester sauce. And then what I'm going to do is take a generous amount of freshly chopped green chilies. So that's almost like 2 green chilies in there, finely chopped, and freshly chopped green coriander leaves. To this, I'm going to add a pinch of salt, a pinch of rock salt or black salt, some chaat masala, and all our brothers and sisters from India would know what it actually feels like to add chaat masala in the drink. And then I'm going to add some lime juice. So approximately about 15 ml of the lime juice. And approximately about 100 ml of tomato juice. Before I add the ice and the vodka, what I have is my secret ingredient for the Saadiwala Bloody Mary. And this one over here is the Maggi seasoning. Okay, so this is the magic ingredient. And what I'm going to do is just almost like a pinch of the same in there. Okay. And finally, 60 ml of vodka. Now, quickly, what I'm going to do is give it a good roll, a couple of times. So, lots of ice. All right. One more time. And then finally take a glass like this, not the roly-poly, but with a glass which has a stem. Lots of ice in there. And then I'm just going to top this glass with the Bloody Mary. And use a slice of cucumber from the side that makes it nice and refreshing. 3 cherry tomatoes as a garnish and some fresh mint sprigs as well. And last but not the least, I will drop a few pepper on top of the drinks to make it nice and peppery and spicy. And there you are, the Balle Balle Bloody Mary from the Big Fat Indian Wedding. Cheers. If you like the Saadiwala Bloody Mary, then please like, comment and subscribe to our YouTube channel 3 Barstools, and also follow us on Instagram.